Lake Health Systems welcomes you to this broadcast of the high school boys varsity basketball game. We are at the Nest of New Bremen, where the Botkins Trojans will take on the New Bremen Cardinals. Tonight's game is being brought to you by the following sponsors: Clopay Building Products, First National Bank, Keyhole Pizza, Winners Meats, Sydney Alglaze Audiology, and NK Telco. Bringing you tonight's game between Botkins and New Bremen. We're just a couple of minutes away from the opening tip of tonight's game. Two teams with different kinds of momentum. Cardinals, they've got six straight wins, including a win over number 7 Kaleida earlier this week, and then a win in MAC play, 57-50 over Parkway. Last loss for the Cardinals way back in early January when they lost 53-51 to St. Mary's in the final seconds of that contest. They're coming off a nice win over league rival Parkway. 27 points by Reese Bussey led the way, and Cardinals enjoyed a 33-21 halftime lead and went on to win by 7 against Parkway and Dylan Hughes, the fine player for the Parkway Panthers. The Trojans, on the other hand, have lost two of their last three games. They lost 61-59 to Anna, and in their last start, 49-40 against Fort Loramie. So they're looking to build some momentum tonight in a non-league matchup between the MAC and Shelby County Athletic League. The Botkins schedule very tough after New Bremen. They come up against number 3 ranked Antwerp. That's their Monday opponent in Division 4 in the Associated Press poll. So we've got a good matchup here on NK Telco Sports. Certainly happy for you to see tonight's game. We'll have our keys to the lineup, keys to the game in our lineup coming up right after our national anthem. Botkins Trojans come into tonight's game with a 12-2 record, 6-2 in league play, a half game behind Anna in the Shelby County Athletic League race. Cardinals 10-4 and 3-2 overall. Now the introduction of our starting lineups tonight, all brought to you by Sydney Alglaze Audiology. Number 0, a senior, Denton Holman. Number 4, a senior, Zane Paul. Number 5, another senior, Jaden Pretty Powell. Number 21, a sophomore, Carter Plyman. And number 35, a junior, Jacob Plyman. So it's Holman, Paul, Pretty Powell, Plyman, and Plyman for the 12-2 Botkins Trojans under the head coaching of Sean Powell. Now for the home team here in the Nest. Cardinals, as we said, winners of six in a row, 10-4 overall. Number two, senior Mitchell Hayes. Number 12, a junior, Nick Allig. Cardinals' leading scorer, number 14, junior Reese Bussey. And junior in the post, number 40, Nathan Rindler. And a senior, number 50, Daniel Holman, playing in the post as well. So it's Hayes, Alec, Bussey, Rindler, and Holman for the Cardinals. Tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Sydney Allglaze Audiology. Keys to the game tonight, as always, brought to you by Keyhole Pizza for the Botkins Trojans. The keys to the game: need to force the tempo. They need to play the tempo that they like. Number two, they also have to contain the efforts of Reese Bussey, who is coming off a 27-point effort against Parkway. And they need to do a good job on the boards. The Cardinals, their keys to the game. Coach Corey Stevens always likes to say they like to set the energy level early. And number two, also need to protect the lane against any kind of penetration by the outside play of Jason Pretty Powell. And solid execution, low turnovers, always important in any basketball game. New Bremen will have the basketball first. We're underway. It's going to go out of bounds and off the Trojans. So the Cardinals will inbound it. Should be a good matchup here. Glad you're along here on NK Telco Sports. Mitchell Hayes out front. He's guarded by Plyman. He'll push it back over to Daniel Holman. Short 15-footer. Shot no good by Holman. Rebound comes down to Botkins, and up court quickly they come. Pretty Powell back over to Carter Plyman. He's open for three. Carter Plyman connects with our first basket of tonight's game. Botkins looking to apply a little bit of man-to-man pressure here. Going to be a turnover by the Cardinals, I believe, stepped on the line. Two teams come in offensively. New Bremen averaging 49.2 points per game. Pretty Powell from outside, and he connects. And Botkins 2-for-2 from downtown and beyond the arc, and they have a quick 6-0 lead against the Cardinals. Bussey inside. He's defended closely there by Holman, but Bussey responds off the glass. Bussey at 14.5 points per game. Plyman's three no good. Rebound to New Bremen and Holman. Pretty Powell ball will be tipped away. Here come the Cardinals on the breakaway. Shot up and in. Basket is good, and Nick Allig will also go to the free throw line. The foul will go against Denton Holman, his first and the team's first. And Allig will step to the free throw line. Nick, a 53% free throw shooter, averaging 5.2 points per game. Lefty shoots and connects. 6-5 our score in the opening minutes of play. Our officials for tonight's game: Frank Vitt, Casey Lee, and Mike Fries officiating tonight's game between Botkins and New Bremen. Pretty Powell with the basketball. Back over to Zane Powell. Carter Plyman will go to the other side. They get it inside to Plyman, who dumps it off to Carter Plyman. Short jumper around and out. Rebound by Botkins, and Plyman will put it up and in. Allie will travel with it. So the Cardinals pick up their second turnover here in the opening moments of play. 5:54 to go on the First National Bank Think First scoreboard. 8-5, Botkins looking for a lift after a couple of tough losses in their last three starts. Jacob Plyman moves inside, uses his left hand, and draws the foul. Foul will go against Bussey. So Jacob Plyman has got 2 points already in tonight's game. We'll go to the free throw line. He'll connect. Plyman, 60% from the free throw line. That's Jacob Plyman, of course. Number 35, second free throw, nothing but net. And Botkins' lead is now 10-5. Alec stepped on the line, so Botkins, good pressure defense that time. Pins Alec right in front of the New Bremen bench, and head coach Corey Stevens of the Cardinals will take a timeout with 5:36 to go. Our score, Botkins 10, New Bremen 5. Denton Holman will inbound the basketball for the Trojans. Pretty Powell, number 5, with the ball. He's working against Nick Alec. Jaden handling it. He'll pull it back out. Assess the situation. Jacob Plyman down low. Carter Plyman will be out in the right wing. Pretty Powell goes into the lane, misses the shot. Rebound down there, and rebound back up by Holman. Also no good. 5-point New Bremen deficit. Bussey. That'll be a turnover. Here come the Botkins Trojans. Paul's shot. No good. There's going to be a foul. I think that's going to go against Nathan Rindler. Substitutes coming off the New Bremen bench. Trevor Bergman and David Holman. Two substitutes also coming off the Trojans bench as well at the 4:57 mark. Second free throw is good by Paul. His first point of the night. 6-point Botkins lead. Bergman up court. He'll take it to the baseline. Feeds Bussey. Shot goes up, and there's going to be a foul. Foul goes against Dylan Topp. Just entered the contest. As did Jamison Meyer. We'll see short on the pair of free throws. 11-5 our score. Plyman, triple team. Holman, or rather Bergman, tips it away. Good steal by Trevor Bergman. Shot no good. It's going to go out of bounds. Hayes back over to Bergman, takes the extra step. Cardinals with 5 turnovers here in the early going. And that's one thing during their streak. They turnovers have been pretty modest. They average 11.3 turnovers per contest. Plyman inside to Plyman. Jacob Plyman tries to make a move, and he'll draw the foul. And that's going to go. See who gets the call this time. Let's just wait and be patient. Rindler and Bussey both there, and it's going to go against Bussey. His second foul with 4:12 to go, so let's see what Coach Corey Stevens does. Looks like Nick Allig will come back into the contest here in just a moment. Plyman's free throw, he's got three in a row. And Bussey will go out with 4:12 to go. Jacob Plyman looking for 6 points, and he's got them in four of them at the free throw line. Botkins going inside tonight here in the opening quarter to Plyman, and he's got six. 13-5 our score, Botkins with an 8-point lead. Holman back over to Bergman. Holman, or Bergman open, and he'll connect, or rather Holman, make that Holman, number 22, David Holman. He'll connect, and that's a big three by David Holman. 5-point Botkins lead, got a foul inside. Foul will go against Jacob Plyman inside. And two teams making some substitutes. Holman and Pretty Powell will come back in. Trevor Bergman. Left side to David Holman. He'll go down the lane. Just inside the free throw line, and he'll connect. So David Holman giving his team a big lift here. He'll tip it away, almost a steal there. Dan Holman will come back in as Nathan Rindler will catch a breather as Coach Stevens rotates his players in and out here in the middle of the third quarter. Turnover by the Trojans. Scrap for the loose basketball, and Botkins is going to come up with it. Pretty Powell, and gets it to Jacob Plyman for three. Shot no good. Rebound comes down to Botkins. Plyman's first three of the night. It's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow will favor Botkins. Rindler will come off the bench. And Holman will come out. Daniel may have gotten hit in the head. Pretty Powell is open. He'll take the three, and he'll connect. Pretty Powell with the three. 16-10, Botkins with the lead. Allig back over to Holman. Shot no good. Inside to Plyman. Big first quarter here for Plyman. 8-point Botkins lead. Definitely Botkins playing at a high level of energy here. Bergman. David Holman down the lane. There's going to be a foul, and that's going to go against the Trojans. It's going to be second foul on Denton Holman. Carter Plyman back in, and also in for the first time, number 23, Tyler Free. Holman tosses it into Allig, top of the key. Holds the basketball. Holman works the baseline. He'll come out to the right side as Mitchell Hayes will handle it. Pretty Powell on him. Holman back over to Bergman. Rindler at the free throw line. Bergman against Myers. Good play there by the Botkins defense, and that's the seventh turnover here in the first quarter for the Cardinals. Pretty Powell with a beautiful move down the lane. He's 3 out of 4 from the field, and it's a 10-point Botkins lead. Tempo just the way the Botkins Trojans like it. In the corner to Hayes. Hayes, he'll get it back out to Bergman. Allig will shoot the three, and he'll connect. Nick Allig's got 6, and boy, that was a huge 3. And it cuts that Botkins lead to 7. Blyman will toss it in to Jaden Pretty Powell, number 5 for Botkins, and it goes to the left side. And Carter Blyman, Meyer, back over to Tyler Free down the lane. He'll make the move. Shot doesn't fall, but he'll draw the foul. Foul will go against Holman. So Tyler Free will step to the free throw line. 67% free throw shooter, and he connects. 5 different scores here in the first quarter for Botkins. Second toss by Free is also good. 22-13. Allig across the timeline. Rindler going to be tipped out of bounds by Pretty Powell. So quick is Pretty Powell, and he tips it away. New Bremen tosses it in. Nathan Rindler will bring it in. Allig will have it. Back out to Rindler for a 15-footer. Shot no good. First quarter in its final minute. And a collision there near midcourt. Daniel Holman will come back into the game here in a moment or so. So I guess we'll rule that a turnover for the Trojans. Hayes will handle it. He's coming across the timeline. Coming up on 40 seconds here left in the first quarter. Bergman, he will travel, and that's a turnover for the Cardinals. Difficult quarter for New Bremen here. Botkins with that 8-9-point lead at 22-13 on the First National Bank Think First scoreboard. Clock counting down. Past 25 seconds. Pretty Powell will handle it in the corner of the half court. They spread it out over to the right side and Meyer. Meyer, clock is at 8 seconds. Meyer's 3-pointer is no good. So our first quarter of play, Botkins 22, New Bremen 13.
Kemmler Orthopedic Center is focused on a personalized, caring approach to treat all aspects of orthopedics, including total joint replacement, shoulder reconstruction, stem cell injections, and more. Dr. James Kemmler and Jed Cooney, certified PA, are dedicated to providing the best orthopedic care in the Grand Lake region. Kemmler Orthopedic Center has offices located in Salina and Van Wert, along with extended evening hours. To schedule an appointment, call our office at 419-586-5760.
Clopay Building Products, America's favorite garage door, is now hiring for all manufacturing and over-the-road CDLA driving positions. Clopay is the largest residential garage door manufacturer in North America, and we are continuing to grow. Join our team and work in a safe, clean, modern environment. Clopay offers a great benefits package, is an equal opportunity employer, and a drug-free work environment. Imagine the possibilities when you open the door to your career at clopaydoor.com/careers.
At First National Bank, we are working hard to make your life a little easier. With products like Card Valet, an app allowing you to control your cards with real-time notifications, transaction restrictions, and spending limits. The ability to access your money through 55,000 all-point ATMs across the country, surcharge-free. Live customer support when you need it. And online and mobile banking, allowing you to gain access to your financial information wherever and whenever you like. First National Bank, making your life a little easier.
Hi, I'm Mallory. My grandpa's been making the world's worst pizza for 30 years.
That doesn't look like the world's worst pizza.
Grandpa, I know why they call you Chunky Bob. It's because you use chunky ingredients on your pizza.
Of course, it's not because I'm fat.
Grandpa, this is the world's best pizza. Keyhole Pizza, come check Grandpa out.
Dine in or carry out.
All Glaze and Sydney Audiology are committed to providing the most advanced and affordable hearing care solutions.
Did you know that more and more insurances are offering coverage for hearing needs and that we are the most comprehensive provider in the area?
Because we want to serve all in our community, we partner with agencies such as Medicaid, OOD, Certoma, and most recently the VA, helping our veterans find local solutions to their problems.
Don't leave unused benefits on the table this year. Call us today to see if you qualify.
Thank you to the following sponsors: Brookside Laboratories, East of Chicago Pizza.
Cardinals will inbound it as we begin the second quarter of basketball. Hayes with it, pretty pal on him. Impressive first quarter of basketball by Botkins, putting 22 points on the board. Reese Bussey back into the Cardinals lineup. He picked up two fouls there in the first quarter. Holman, ball is loose, and that's going to be a Cardinal turnover. They're just plagued by mishaps here in the first half so far. Got nine turnovers. Normally they only have about 11 per game as their average. Pretty Powell will inbound it. Carter Plyman with the basketball. It's going to be tipped out of bounds by Alec. Plyman tosses it into Pretty Powell. Head coach Sean Powell shouting instructions to his team. Dylan Topp in the lineup for the Trojans. He's number 14, Pretty Powell. He'll go down the lane, back out to Top. Over to Jacob Plyman. In the corner to Carter Plyman, double team there. Back out to Pretty Powell. Nice move inside, puts a shot up, no good. Rebound Cardinals and Reese Bussey. Inside it goes to Holman. They're gonna call a charge. Trevor Bergman will come in. Charge foul gets the fans here tonight on their feet, so to speak. Meyer, top of the key, pretty in Powell. He'll go to the free throw line, dumps it off to Kleiman, but it Cardinals defense reacts and creates that turnover. Bussey, top of the key, over to Alec in the corner. Alec back out front to Trevor Bergman. Meyer on Bussey. Alec now with the basketball. Hayes, Trevor Bergman, Daniel Holman. Cardinals trying to work it. Approaching the 6 minute mark, they're down by 9 points as we enter the second quarter. Bussey back out to Bergman. Trying to get that open shot, and the Botkins defense doing a pretty good job here. Pass on the baseline, that's a turnover, and good defense by Botkins prevents a score. St. Paul will come back into the game for Botkins as Dylan Topp will go out. Botkins averages 51.8 points per game coming into the weekend. And on defense, they allow 43 points. From the field, they shoot 46.7%. So good shooting team, and they're showing it so far here in the first half. Meyer, shot no good, but Bergman will draw the foul, or will commit the foul, rather, and that's going to send Jamison Meyer to the free throw line. He's going to get three shots. Meyer, a 56% free throw shooter, coming into the weekend. Botkins 7 out of 8 in the first quarter at the free throw line. Now 8 for 10 as they've been going to the line here quite a bit in the first half. Second free throw also good, so Myers picks up a couple of his first 2 points of the night. Cardinals are now down by 11 points. New Bremen's offense trying to get some motion. Alec back over to Hayes. He goes inside. Myers with the steal. Meyer looks for Kleiman, but he's going to travel. Botkins, on the other hand, they average 9.8 turnovers. And so far here tonight, they've got about 5 here as we approach the midway point of the second quarter. Inside, Bussey likes it in there. Nice feed to Alec, shot no good. Pass goes through Bussey's legs and Free puts a shot up. Kleiman's shot no good. Down the lane is Bussey, and he'll draw the foul. Jacob Kleiman picks up his second foul. That's the fifth team foul, and Bussey will go to the line. He'll connect. Had to sit out a little over 4 minutes in that first quarter after he picked up 2 fouls. Bussey's got 3 points on the night. Kyle Tinkman into the lineup for New Bremen. Bussey's free throw is good. Dylan Topp will come into the game for New Bremen, and Jacob Kleiman will catch a break at the 425 mark. St. Paul, guarded closely by Nick Alec. Paul goes to the left side and the corner there. Back out to Carter Kleiman. Over in the right to Meyer for 3. Shot no good. Rebound to the Cardinals. Down the lane, Mitchell Hayes his first basket of the night. Timeout, Botkins. 3:58 to go here in the second period. Our score, Botkins 24, New Bremen 17. St. Paul will bring it up court on the timeout by Botkins. They take a brief break. 3:48 to go, opening quarter basketball. They have an 8-point lead. Paul with the basketball. He's at the top of the key. Meyer back over to Plyman. Plyman looks inside. They'll continue to work behind the arc. Down low by Holman. He finds Top, and Top has his first basket of the night. Nice assist by Denton Holman. Lead at 9 points for Botkins. Reese Bussey. Mitchell Hayes looks inside, finds his man. And Kyle Tinkman, senior, will go to the free throw line. Tinkman, a pretty good free throw shooter. In the opportunities that he's had so far this season, 75% free throw shooter. Misses the first. Jacob Plyman will come back in, as does Pretty Powell, and Paul will go out. Tankman's second free throw is good. Senior picks up his first point of the night, 26-18, 8-point Botkins lead. Top back over to Carter Plyman on the baseline. It's going to be tipped away there by Nathan Rindler. Nice defense as he protects the baseline. Carter Plyman, Pretty Powell. He'll try to go inside. He'll move it back out to Top. Top to Jacob Plyman. He's going to shoot the three. Shot no good. Rebound comes down to Botkins. Turnover, and New Bremen will have the basketball. Alec working across the timeline. Over to Tankman. Tankman goes inside. There's Alec. He's open. Shot a little bit short. Botkins with the rebound. Steal. Shot back up. No good. Botkins with the rebound. And Meyer way off target. Botkins gets the rebound. Shot from outside. No good. Wild exchange here. And boy, the shooting percentages in this quarter are going to definitely go down. Got a whistle, and the two officials will confer. 2:07 to go here in the first half. And trying to sort through things here. Foul goes against Botkins, and Bussey will go to the line. Reese, 2 out of 5 from the free throw line. Let's see if he can get to 500, and he does, 50% rather. 3 out of 6 at the line. He's got 5 on the night. Botkins with the basketball. Pretty Powell over to Meyer. Inside it goes to Carter Plyman. Bussey on him. Carter Plyman tries to make the move. Shot goes up, no good. Second quarter is really a whole different kind of game. Hayes back over to Alec. Open. Tankman's shot goes in and out. It's a travel and two teams just exchanging turnovers so far tonight. Unofficially, of course, New Bremen with 13 turnovers. And Botkins with 6 so far. Tankman back over to Bussey. Alec has it. Tankman runs the cut. He's in the corner. Rindler goes down to the baseline. Tankman in the corner with the ball inside Rindler. Rindler back out to Tankman. Tankman looks inside. Nice pass. Shot goes up. No good. Hayes puts it up. Let's see what the call is. So Hayes will go to the line as the foul is on Pretty Powell, his second. Hayes looking to connect on the free throw shoot. Free throws, only 42% on the season for Hayes. He'll toss his second as Bussey will go out with 57 seconds left here in the first half. Second free throw is good. And the difference in this one is 6 points, 26-20. Botkins had 22 points in that explosive first quarter of play. Pretty Powell with the ball, looks inside. They'll go back out and around. Hayes goes for the steal. Paul will connect on the three. Big shot by Zane Paul. He's got 4 points on his first made three of the night. Tankman back to Hayes. Hayes. It's going to go the other way. It's going to be a New Bremen turnover. Officials will confer. Trying to get it right. And New Bremen will maintain the basketball. Tip there by Botkins. Of course, it happens right in front of head coach Sean Powell and the Botkins bench. Hayes will have it as the clock is coming down to 15 seconds on the First National Bank Think First scoreboard. Daniel Holman back over to Tankman. Inside, Alec, shot doesn't go, and here come Botkins. They'll turn it over as well. At the buzzer. Not quite there, Nick Alec shot. So our halftime score, Botkins 29, New Bremen 20.
Hello, New Bremen. I'm Matt Everidge with NK Telco, and we're here for you for your cable, telephone, and internet services.
Hey, Minster, this is Nate Henry with NK Telco, and we're here for you for your existing cable TV, internet, and phone service.
Hey, New Knoxville, I am Wesley Meyer at NK Telco. We are here for you and your customer service needs.
Hey, Maria Stein, I'm Ken with NK Telco, and we are here for you with hometown pride.
Together, we are family, working safely for our loved ones.
We are problem solvers who challenge the status quo and drive improvement.
We care about our customer relationships.
We stay true to our values, caring and respecting one another.
We embrace change as we journey through our career.
We are Precision Strip, the world's leading processor of rolled steel and aluminum.
Precision Strip, doing the exceptional.
Carriage Works has expanded and now can hold up to 25 cars in our service bay. Carriage Works thrives on customer satisfaction. We accomplish that by providing top-of-the-line technology. Carriage Works now uses a laser beam system to measure down to the millimeter of factory specs to better service you and get you back on the road. Carriage Works has a brand new top-of-the-line paint booth that uses waterborne paint. There's no job too big or too small for Carriage Works. We are certified collision specialists. Come in and see us today.
Here's the thing. If you're the kind of guy who eats, sleeps, and breathes farming, who gets up at dawn, determined to get the best crop and the best yield, why surrender to the mercy of the water table? Cy Schwederman Incorporated can lower your water table to an average of 2 to 3 feet below the surface, allowing you to grow stronger, healthier plants that root deeper, that are more resilient to the elements, that enable longer growing seasons, and can produce higher results in the fields and in your pocket. Trust CSI, your drainage expert since 1946.
At Minster Bank, we understand that life can get hectic. That's why, when it comes to your banking, we offer the services that make your life simpler, with tools like person-to-person payments, Pop Money, mobile and online banking, and bill pay. But most of all, Minster Bank is a supportive member of your community, with personal relationships and customer service that reach outside of our branches. Minster Bank, helping people achieve financial success.
At Home and Interiors, our team loves to design beautiful yet cost-effective projects. From sleek and simple to elaborate and detailed, we customize to fit your tastes and budget with free interior design and color coordination. Visit our 5,000 square foot kitchen design center and bring your next project to life. Full custom kitchen and bath cabinets are built right here in New Bremen. Home and Interiors, your vision designed for your budget.
Please support the following sponsors: Forever Fit, Rachel's Cakes, Speedway Lanes, Bomber Construction, Jewelry Barn, Tom and Jerry's, Western Ohio Mortgage.
Back here at the Nest in New Bremen, Cardinals find themselves down to Botkins, 29-20. Let's take a look at our first half numbers. For the Botkins Trojans, they were 8 out of 24 from the field. They had 4 out of 10 behind the arc and 9 out of 11 at the free throw line for a total of 29 points. New Bremen, on the other hand, 6 out of 17 overall from the field, 2 out of 5 from behind the arc, and 6 out of 9 at the free throw line for a total of 20 points. The board battle belongs to Botkins, 16-10. Turnovers, definitely the problem for the Cardinals in the first half. They had 13 turnovers, including 8 in the first quarter compared to 7 for the Botkins Trojans. First quarter of play is really the story so far, as the Trojans jumped out to a 22-13 lead, getting the basketball inside to Jacob Plyman, who scored all of his 8 points in that opening quarter. One basket and then two baskets and then 4 for 4 at the free throw line. He led the Trojans along with Jaden Pretty Powell with 8 points. Others in the scoring column for Botkins: Zane Paul with 4, Carter Plyman with 3, Tyler Free with 2, Dylan Tupp with 2, and Jamison Meyer with 2 points. Cardinals, on the other hand, were led by Nick Allig with 6. Reese Bussey had 5, as did David Holman. Botkins will have the basketball, and Plyman will put it up. Muscle play, and he connects. And the lead goes to 11 points. Plyman now into double figures with 10 points. Free throw is good. He's hit all 5 of his free throws. He's got 11 now in tonight's game. Hayes with the basketball for the Cardinals as they work it over to the right side. Alec guarded by Paul. Rindler will come out, as does Jacob Plyman. Hayes will handle the basketball. Pretty Powell on him. Rindler back over to Alec. 32-20 our score. Bussey, nice pass inside to Holman. Daniel Holman will score his first basket of the night. here to start the second half of play. Pretty Powell will pick up his third personal, so a big foul for the Trojans, and Holman connects. Two teams exchange three-point plays here as we open the third quarter. Paul with the basketball. Zane looks inside. He'll go back out, and around the perimeter goes the passing of the Trojans. Jacob Powell inside, double-teamed. He puts it up. Foul will occur before the shot. So that's going to go against Rindler. That's his second. And Botkins will inbound it. 7:04 to go here in the third quarter on the First National Bank Think First scoreboard. Inside to Holman. Back out to Carter Plyman. Pretty Powell will try to go to the lane. Stops at the free throw line. Carter Plyman for three, and he connects. He's got 6 points on the night. 2 for 3 from behind the arc for the sophomore. And it's 35-23. And the Cardinals will throw it away. And it's going to be a foul in the backcourt. That's going to go against Reese Bussey. That's his third. And quickly off the bench comes David Holman. So Bussey goes to the bench with 6:31 to go here in the second, in the third quarter. Paul will have it. Botkins with that 12-point lead. Pretty Powell, top of the key. He'll go to the right side, down the lane, dishes it off. Shot no good. Rebound comes down to DeBreeman. Cardinals running their offense. 6 minutes to play. Third quarter, Holman with the basketball. Down the lane, back over to Halleck. Holman will go to the corner. Out front is Hayes. Holman back over to Halleck. Rindler runs a cut. So does Hayes. Down the lane. Halleck finds Holman. Shot no good. Jacob Plyman with a rebound. Jacob Plyman moves inside. Going to call 3 seconds. Toppenmeyer will come in. As Plyman and Pretty Powell will catch a breather. 5:24 to go and a 12-point lead. David Holman over in the right side. It goes to Halleck. Halleck back over to Rindler. Rindler finds Halleck underneath the basket. He'll come back out, but it's going to be a double dribble, and that's a turnover for the Cardinals. Turnovers the problem so far here in tonight's game for New Bremen. They've got 15 so far, well above their normal average for the season of 11. Paul will handle the basketball. Rindler's on him. Carter Plyman over to Meyer. They work it around the arc. Carter Plyman to Paul. He's open. He'll take it. Shot no good. Rebound to the Cardinals. Paul had a nice look, but it just didn't fall. Paul will pick up the foul as Trevor Bergman will re-enter the lineup for the Cardinals. Hayes over to Halleck. Down low to Rindler. Rindler dumps it off to Holman. Shot blocked. Rebound to Botkins. Turnover. Here come the Cardinals. Shot no good by Holman. Trojans grab the rebound. Carter Plyman to the corner. Back out to Zane Paul. Paul gets it to Plyman. Almost taken away by Mitchell Hayes. Great quickness there by Mitchell Hayes, but we've got a timeout. 30-second timeout by the Cardinals. 4:02 remains in the third quarter of play. I'd like to remind you that NK Telco Sports and its sponsors are pleased to bring you replays of high school basketball on NK Telco Channel 3 or in HD on Channel 503. Sunday, January 31st at 4 p.m. and Monday, February the 1st at 9 p.m. You can also watch more games on demand through YouTube, Facebook, and at nktelco.com/sports. 35-23 our score. Cardinals take the timeout. Carter Plyman in front of the Botkins bench will toss it in. Paul will have it. He's out front. Pretty Powell with it. Guarded by Hayes. Short jumper by Pretty Powell. And Jaden will get the roll, and he goes into double figures with 10 points on that made basket. Nice soft touch by Pretty Powell, and the lead is at 14 points for Botkins. Holman over in the corner to Alec. Rindler trying to make the move inside. Shot no good. Botkins quickly get the ball to Paul in the corner. Shot no good. And Cardinals quickly up court. Bergman will shoot. It's going to be a foul. And the call goes against the Cardinals. That'll be Trevor Bergman's second foul. Pretty Powell. There's the steal. Alec. Quick bucket to Rindler. Nathan Rindler with his first basket of the night. Cuts the Botkins lead to 12. Meyer back over to Paul. Over to the right side it goes to Pretty Powell. He goes to the baseline. Back out to Jacob Plyman. Almost tipped away there by Bergman. Pretty Powell goes inside, dishes it off to Top, and it's going to go out of bounds and off Top. Fourth turnover in the third quarter for Botkins. Reese Bussey will come into the lineup here on the next dead ball. Alec, and there's going to be a foul there by Top. That's his second. 13th foul of the half, and Reese Bussey will come back into the lineup. Bussey inside to Rindler, trying to move on. Jacob Plyman, shot no good. Nice move by Rindler, it just doesn't fall. Pretty Powell. Paul puts it on the floor. And you can be the judge on that one. Be the fourth foul of the half for the Trojans. 2:25 to go, third period of action. Hayes across the timeline. Paul on him. Hayes looks inside as Bussey cuts to the corner. Rindler comes out for the pass. Bergman. Holman for three. Shot no good. Rebound. New Bremen. Bussey back out. It's going to be a blocking foul. And going to have a discussion as two officials change their mind. Never a good thing to have happen. As we wait in suspense for the call. Explanation is made. Scorers table nodding their heads. Double foul. Don't see that very often. Basket will count. Explanations made to all coaches. Big thing for Botkins, though, is that Pretty Powell picks up his fourth foul with 2:05 here in the third period of play. So the basket goes to Hayes. So Hayes has five on the night. It's a 10-point lead for Botkins. Confusing call, and it's really tough for us to explain what took place, but the basket counted. It looked like the foul occurred after the shot, apparently. Here we go, back to action. Plyman with the basketball. Jacob, nice move inside. Triple team puts it up and in. 1:39 to go here in a wild third quarter. Holman puts it up, and he'll be called with the charge. Two teams, especially New Bremen, taking it to the hoop. That'll go against David Holman. That's his third. That's the Cardinals' sixth foul. So we are on the verge of having quite a few free throws shot here in the fourth quarter. 1:32 left here in quarter number three. Paul, he'll walk it up court across the timeline. Hayes on him. Plyman picked up there by Hayes. Meyer with the basketball, handling it out front. Hayes is on him. Inside it goes to Jacob Plyman. Over in the corner to Paul. Makes the move inside. Back out to Meyer. Back out Holman at the free throw line. Carter Plyman gets it inside to Jacob. He dishes it right back to Carter Plyman. And Carter Plyman has his seventh and eighth points of the night. 14-point Botkins lead. Hayes thinks about it. Back over to Bussey. Bussey over to Holman. Holman, Bussey has it at the free throw line. Trying to move inside. He's double teamed. Ball taken away. And the result is a turnover. Here comes Carter Plyman. We're at 39 seconds. In the corner it goes to Meyer. They get it down low to Holman. Holman back to Meyer. Meyer back out front to Paul. Carter Plyman looks inside for Jacob. Dishes it off. They do the reverse of the last time. And Jacob Plyman has 15 on the night. Strong move by Jacob Plyman. And the lead extended to 16 points. Jacob and Carter Plyman go inside like that. That's tough to stop for any team. And the Cardinals having some problems here in the third period with that combination. Cardinals need a basket. 10 seconds left. Bussey with it. Going to try and make a move. Carter Plyman on him. David Holman. There's Bussey in the corner. Shot no good. So Bussey's three off target. Our third quarter score, Botkins 43 and New Bremen 27.
Grand Lake Foot and Ankle Center offers a family-friendly environment with a personalized approach to reduce pain, restore function, and improve mobility. Dr. Christopher Stuckey specializes in reconstructive foot and ankle surgery, diabetic foot care, trauma including fractures and sports injuries, along with bunions, hammer toes, and ingrown toenails. Grand Lake Foot and Ankle Center has offices located in St. Mary's and Salina. To schedule an appointment, call our office at 419-394-8664.
Clopay Building Products, America's favorite garage door, is now hiring for all manufacturing and over-the-road CDLA driving positions. Clopay is the largest residential garage door manufacturer in North America, and we are continuing to grow. Join our team and work in a safe, clean, modern environment. Clopay offers a great benefits package, is an equal opportunity employer, and a drug-free work environment. Imagine the possibilities when you open the door to your career at clopaydoor.com/careers.
Hey, Minster, this is Nate Henry with NK Telco, and we're here for you for your existing cable TV, internet, and phone service.
Hey, Botkins, I'm Brett Gerstner with NK Telco, and we are here for you and to help you operate your business network.
Hey, Maria Stein, I'm Ken with NK Telco, and we are here for you with Hometown Pride.
Hi, Rishi. I'm Tim Metzger, and we are here for you for your installation of your telephone, cable TV, and internet.
Contact NK Telco at 1-888-NK-TELCO. For over 150 years, Cargill has been helping people be successful worldwide. Cargill has always done business responsibly and in a way that makes us proud. Whether it is educating farmers in India or providing bikes to students with perfect attendance right here at home, Cargill is helping people thrive. The Sydney plant is just one piece of a global company that provides employment for hundreds of thousands, food for the world, and support for thousands of businesses. Be a part of something great at Cargill.com.
Thank you to the following sponsors: Cargill, Victory Machine, Hometown Opportunity, Kogi Plumbing and Heating, Wagner's IGA, Huelsman Automotive.
Third quarter, a good shooting quarter for the Botkins Trojans. 6 out of 10 from the field overall. And they increase their lead to 16 points after a 9-point lead at halftime here at the Nest in New Bremen. Good solid quarter by Botkins and puts them in front. Entering the final 8 minutes of play as the officials discussing things with the scorers table, so there must be some kind of issue there. New Bremen, on the other hand, 3 out of 10 in that quarter. Overall, though, the big issue for the Cardinals is 16 turnovers so far through three quarters of play. Board battle belongs to Botkins, 22 to 14 turnovers. As we said, Botkins with a high number for them. They've got 11 so far. 14 to 7, Botkins outscores New Bremen in that third quarter, and New Bremen will have the basketball. Holman back over to Hayes. Hayes looks down low, outside 3-point shot by Bergman, no good. In the corner is Holman again, shot no good. New Bremen still maintaining the basketball. Bussey back over to Bergman. Hayes tries to go inside, cut off there by Top. Bussey will take the three, and he'll connect. Reese Bussey, a welcome three, and it's a 13-point Botkins lead. Paul with the basketball, Bergman on him. Carter Plyman. Of course, Jason Pretty Powell not in the lineup. And Trojans are going to turn it over. They're going to escape the bullet. Jaden Pretty Powell will come into the game here in a moment, as does Nick Allig for New Bremen. Plyman will catch a breather at 6:33. That's Jacob Plyman. He's got 17 points as we enter the fourth quarter. Pretty Powell back, passes it off to Powell. Paul back out over, there's the steal. Holman up and in. David Holman with the steal. And it's going to be a Trojan turnover. Hayes across the timeline. 11-point difference in this one. Bussey back over to Holman. Alec over on the right side. Holman goes inside the lane. Bussey to the baseline. Nice move. Puts it up, but he'll draw the foul. That's going to go against Denton Holman. That's the sixth team foul. So both teams have six team fouls. So we'll be going into the one-on-one shortly. Bussey will connect. Jacob Plyman back into the game for the Trojans. Second free throw, no good. Holman with the rebound. Ball goes to the corner, and Botkins will have it. Pretty Powell coming up across the timeline. Nathan Rindler will come into the game in a moment for the Cardinals. Pretty Powell wants to drive. In it goes, back out to Plyman. Trojans with a 10-point lead. We'll be patient here. Clock at 5.5 minutes to play in this one. They got off to that great first quarter start, and that's what New Bremen has faced for almost the entire night. 22-13, Botkins with a big 8-point lead after the first 8 minutes, and they've been able to increase it by a bucket. And Pretty Powell looking for the baseline runner. Rindler comes in. Paul will come in for Botkins. Holman across the timeline. Nathan Rindler to his left. Hayes runs the cut. He'll get the pass. Back to Rindler, who tries to work the baseline. Blocking foul there by Jamison Meyer. His second, team seventh, so that's going to send Nathan Rindler to the free throw line for our first 1-1 of the night. He connects. 9-point Botkins lead. As we said, the Trojans trying to capture some momentum with a win here against New Bremen. Full timeout by New Bremen with 4:59 to play in this one. Our score, Botkins 43 and New Bremen 35. Thank you. First National Bank Think First scoreboard, 4:59 to play, 43-35. Botkins with the lead after the New Bremen timeout. Denton Holman will toss it in for the Trojans. Gets it into Zane Paul, guarded closely by Mitchell Hayes. Paul goes to the left side. Boy, talk about two athletes there, Paul and Hayes. One a soccer standout, another an outstanding football player for the Cardinals state championship team. Botkins, of course, powerhouse in soccer. Zane Paul, an all-state performer. So Carter Plyman steps to the line, and he'll connect. One thing that the Trojans have done very, very well here tonight, 11 out of 13 at the free throw line. Second free throw also good. 12 out of 14 now for Botkins at the free throw line. Holman double teamed in the corner. Back out to Rindler, tipped away by Jacob. Plyman, loose basketball, it goes to the floor. Paul will push it up to Meyer, up to Plyman. They'll get it over to Paul. Plyman in the corner, back out front to Meyer. Paul will have it on the wing. Dribbles down the lane. Back over to Carter. Plyman to Meyer, and Botkins with 4:08 to go. They'll be patient. Almost a steal, and there it is. Alec has his hands on it. Ball still loose. Jacob Plyman has it off to Denton Holman. He loses it, goes out of bounds. And boy, what a tough run there for the Botkins Trojans. It took about 15 seconds off the clock there, and just kind of a wild exchange as Holman and Meyer will come out. Mitchell Hayes inside to Bussey. Bussey working on top. Shot no good. Rebounded to Plyman. Ball goes on the floor, and it's going to be a blocking foul, and that's going to go against Nick Alec. As boy, you heard the thump, and that's going to put Botkins at the line. Trojans entering tonight's game. 111 out of one, or rather, yeah, entering the weekend, I should say, 111 out of 175 at the line. That's 63%+. Second free throw, a little bit short. New Bremen needs a score. From the corner, Alec. Shot rims in. Oh, for the first time tonight, it feels like the Cardinals got a roll. Alec, 9 points on the night. On that made three, Botkins are going to counter. They're in the one and one. They can handle the ball very, very well. And they can work the clock as we come up on 3 minutes on that First National Bank Think First scoreboard. And there's a foul and a couple of Carter Plyman went to the basket. Boy, Holman fell on him and quite a collision. But fortunately, they're both okay, and Plyman will go to the line. Misses the free throw. Carter Plyman, a 62% free throw shooter. Gets two of them, averages 10.1 points per game. Second free throw is good. He's got 12 here tonight. And the Trojans really are going to go to the free throw line, and Cardinals are going to have to hope that they miss a few. Holman on the baseline, off the glass, up and in. David Holman, nice move on the baseline and a nice bucket. Botkins will maintain possession. Carter Plyman back over to top. Top with it. He'll bring it across the timeline. Paul goes inside. Top will get it over to Plyman. Paul's going to try and sneak inside. He'll pull it back out. Got a timeout, Botkins. 2:20 to go. They'll take a 30-second timeout. So we'd like to remind you that NK Telco Sports and its sponsors are pleased to bring you replays of high school basketball on NK Telco Channel 3 or in HD on Channel 503, Sunday, January 31st at 4 p.m. and Monday, February the 1st at 9 p.m. You can also watch more games on demand through YouTube, Facebook, and at nktelco.com/sports. NK Telco Sports, another good one here. Botkins and New Bremen doing battle. Trojans jumped out to a 22-13 lead in the first quarter. 22 out of their 47 points. They hit 6 out of 13 from the field, 3 out of 5 from behind the arc, and 7 out of 8 at the line to start the game. Cardinals have been battling back ever since. Botkins had a 9-point halftime lead. Pretty Powell with the ball, dishes it off. Beautiful assist. Easy bucket for Jacob Plyman, who's got 17 on the night. He averages 15.2 points per game on the baseline. Alec will shoot it back out to Bussey. Shot off the iron. Battle for the rebound comes down to Botkins. Trevor Bergman will come off the New Bremen bench. Alec will pick up his second. And that puts Botkins in the double bonus. And Jaden Pretty Powell connects on the free throw. Powell averages 14.7 points per game. Good free throw shooter. A little above 70%, and he'll hit the second. He's got 12 in the lead now at 11. 1:45 to go. Alec shot no good. Rebound to the Trojans. Now a scramble. Timeout for New Bremen. 1:35 to go in this one. Botkins 51, New Bremen 40. Botkins with the 11-point lead and looking to pick up their 13th win of the season in 15 games. Of course, they face Antwerp, a state-ranked team in Division IV on Monday. So a busy stretch for the Trojans. Bergman shot no good. Pretty Powell with the rebound. Cardinals just not hitting their threes in this quarter. But because of that 11-point deficit, they're forced to fire them up there. Jaden Pretty Powell. He'll knock it home. Jaden, 49% shooter from the field. As we said, 14.7 points per game, and he's right at that average. Hayes leads Alec back to Bussey. Back out front to Holman. Holman trying to make something happen. Bergman, he'll shoot from behind the arc. Shot no good. Rebound comes down to Bussey, and he'll put it up and in. 53-42 in the First National Bank Think First scoreboard. Paul in the corner. There's the steal. Hayes, he'll lay it up and in. Fifth turnover of the quarter for Botkins. Going to be a foul on the inbounds pass. 47.7 seconds. Botkins up by 9. Jaden Pretty Powell, the senior, steps to the line, shooting a couple of more free throws. Second free throw is good. Almost all of the scoring except for a basket coming at the free throw line here in the fourth quarter for Botkins. Alec. Pass stolen by Botkins, and the Trojans will have it and inbound it. Carter Plyman will toss it in. New Bremen will see their six-game winning streak stopped here tonight as we count down the final seconds. There's the reach by number 5. That's Trevor Bergman. His fourth. 21, sophomore Carter Plyman. 62% free throw shooter. Averaging 10.1 points per game and about 5 rebounds. Free throw a little bit short. Here comes number 2. It's good at 55-44. Holman, he'll lose it. Plyman tosses it up to Jacob Plyman. They'll just hang on to it or try to. Pretty Powell with the basketball. Over to Paul. Final seconds. Toss it back out front, and that's going to be it. The clock counts down. And our final score here tonight, Botkins 55 and New Bremen 44. Nice finish to the game for the Botkins Trojans as they do a nice job at the line. Once again, our final score, Botkins 55, New Bremen 44. And in a moment, we'll be back with a recap.
The Hometown Opportunity Platform is exceptional.
It is focused, laser focused, on the careers in our four county region.
100% of the time we go to Hometown Opportunity. We've had great success from a handful of applications when we need them, as well as a recent one where we had 67 applicants.
Honestly, it's a competitive advantage.
The hometown experience has been everything I could have dreamed of and more.
Togi Plumbing and Heating is your Bryant Factory authorized dealer. We have brought the best of comfort, control, and plumbing services to the St. Mary's area for over 60 years. We have been Reader's Choice winners for the last 4 years running and excel at providing our customers with efficient and reliable heating and air conditioning, as well as responsive service when a plumbing emergency arises. We insist that the products we install in our customers' homes and businesses offer the same performance and value that we expect ourselves. Call today for your next plumbing and heating or air conditioning needs. Bryant, whatever it takes.
Our bankers are working hard day and night to provide the support needed right now. Even while we're apart, we're proudly working together, with you and for you. We believe there's more, much more, to all of us than these tough times. We see acts of compassion and cooperation all around our communities, and we're proud to be a part of it. And as our family of banks come together under our Park National Bank name, we promise you, we're all in this together.
Wagner's IGA has been servicing their communities for more than 95 years, spanning three generations. Wagner's founded their business on two basic principles: excellent customer service and quality products. Visit all our locations and experience the finest selection of deli, fresh meats, and variety of beverage choices. While there, don't forget to check out our vast selection of fresh coffee beans, produce, dairy, and bakery items. Visit Wagner's today in Minster, Fort Laramie, and New Bremen, and check us out on Facebook.
Today's game is being brought to you by Grand Lake Health, Clopay Building Products, First National Bank, Keyhole Pizza, Winners Meats, Sydney Anglaise Audiology, NK Telco.
Back here at New Bremen, the Cardinals' winning streak is snapped at six games by the Botkins Trojans. A very impressive finish for the Trojans as they move to 13-2 overall. New Bremen falls to 10-5. Taking a look at the statistics for tonight's game, first for the Cardinals, they were 15 out of 41 from the field, 4 out of 16 from behind the arc, shot very well at the free throw line, 10 out of 14. On the boards, the Cardinals had 18 rebounds, unfortunately 27 for the Botkins Trojans, as they had the edge there. But the key fact for the Cardinals, they had 20 turnovers in tonight's game, 13 in the first half, 8 in the opening quarter, while Botkins, for them, they had 15 turnovers, but overcame that as they had that 8-point lead built up in the first quarter, maintained it throughout tonight's contest, and then simply shot free throws in the fourth and final quarter. Botkins, 20 out of 26 overall from the free throw line, did a great job in that final quarter just to put the game away once they started to go to the free throw line. So a nice win for the Trojans, as hopefully they can pick up some momentum. They got a state-ranked team in Antwerp coming up on Monday. And then, of course, they get back into to league, Shelby County Athletic League play, and hopefully the march for the championship for that conference. New Bremen, on the other hand, they'll play at Versailles in their next contest. The Cardinals stand 3-2 in league play, but tonight the Cardinals simply got down early. And when you take a look at the first quarter of play tonight, Botkins, 6 out of 13 from the field, hit 3 out of 5 on threes and 7 out of 8 at the line as they went inside to Jacob Plyman, who had a very, very nice game. Now, Jacob has been our player of the game probably many times this year, so tonight we're going to have another player who did very well on the free throw line here in the fourth and final quarter, our player of the game tonight, sponsored by NK Telco, sophomore Carter Plyman. He had a good second half, came out in the third quarter, hit a three, followed it up with another basket, and then hit four free throws in that fourth and final quarter and had a nice night with 13 points. So our player of the game tonight is Carter Plyman for the Botkins Trojans. I'd like to remind you that tonight's game is brought to you by the following sponsors: Clopay Building Products, First National Bank, Keyhole Pizza, Winners Meats, Sydney Anglaise Audiology, and NK Telco. Also follow WCSM AM 1350, 96.7 FM, and their internet exclusive games on WCSMradio.com all season, your sports leader in Mercer and all Glaze counties. NK Telco Sports and its sponsors are pleased to bring you replays of high school basketball on NK Telco Channel 3 or in HD on Channel 503 Sunday, January 31st at 4 p.m. and Monday, February the 1st at 9 p.m. You can also watch more games on demand through YouTube, Facebook, and at nktelco.com/sports. I'm Dave Helmstetter. Once again, from the Nest in New Bremen, our final score, the Botkins Trojans 55 and the New Bremen Cardinals 44.